Hello friends, welcome to the latest lecture of Staad Pro classes. Today we are going to discuss about how to make a shear wall and how to have its analysis, right? So before going into the topic of how to make a shear wall, which is pretty easy, let's first understand. I wanted to give a brief introduction about what is a shear wall and why is it necessary in our buildings. So at first let me show you a picture. This is what is known as a shear wall. We readily find this in the structures, in the buildings that we see these days. So this, the wall is totally made up of RCC. We have steel reinforcement within that, we have reinforcement within that, and in the plan it shows like this. So why is that we provide a shear wall? It is due to this that the shear wall gives a stiffness to the structure, and thus our stall structures behaves in a way like this, in a uniform way like this. See, the position of the maximum slope is where the maximum forces occur. So actually in earthquakes, cases like earthquake, what we want is that the energy to dissipate. So a uniform curve like this helps us to dissipate a lot of energy. So that is why this curve is more reliable, more desirable exactly, because if we have a curve like this, the highest slope is here. So that is why the maximum stresses occur here. As a result, we may see failures like this. This is a typical building where just you see on the corner, after one floor, there is a huge pressure that develops because of this phenomenon. Correct, this is a very high building, this is just a three-story building. Just in also a three-story building, we can find this sort of issues, right? So that is why we go for a shear wall. So the shear wall provides large strength and stiffness to our building in the direction of their orientation, which significantly reduces lateral sway of the building and thus reduces damage to a structure and its contents, right? Since shear walls carry large horizontal earthquake forces, the overturning effects on them are very large. For instance, if we go for the force diagram, you can see here is the lateral forces. Here we have the tension. The stuff expands here and we have the contraction here. So this reinforcement is the resistance at the bond ratio that we give, the tension to resist rotation here, and the tension to resist the compression of the rotation. So basically we have the torsional moment in the shear wall. So after this brief introduction, let's jump into how to build a shear wall. For this I have installed a bay frame structure here. And we'll go on to design the shear wall for this structure. So for this, what we need to do is go to the 4-threaded plate cursor and then add our very own 4-threaded plates one by one. We will be having a shear wall on this face. Say I will be making one shear wall, right? So we have made a shear wall. We've made this a shear wall. Correct. Now let's keep the dimensions. Let's define. Then let's have rectangular. Let's have the beams and columns of one dimension only. 400 by say 400. All beams and columns, let's have them as this. And let's define section thickness, plate element thickness as 0.25, add close. So for rectangular, I think let's assign it to view, assign, yes. So the whole structure becomes assigned with this. For plate thickness, use cursor to assign, assign. Let's assign them one by one. We have assigned them, right? So now let's go for the, before going to the loads and definition, let's see the 3D of that one. We'll get a better idea. Just see, we have the beams and the columns. Just you can see here the offset for checking out this offset, you can visit my offset video, how to remove these offsets. And then you have this whole shear wall thing here. You can have the thickness from the bottom. You can see the shear wall. See, you can view. I can bring this one up here. Better view of this one. Just see, we have the shear wall, and on the sides we have the column, just like this. In this manner, two columns surrounding a shear wall. Fine. So let's go to the loads and cases and definitions. We'll be only analyzing it with primarily only dead load. Say load case one, let's give it as dead. Add close, let us add the self weight only. This is just a primary thing that I am doing just to show you how to make a shear wall, in order to which loads I have to add, which direction I have to add. I have already lectures of that. You can visit them and see. Assign to view, assign, yes. So in short way, we will be assigning, in a very short manner, we will be just making the shear wall design, fine. So after loads and definitions, let's go to design, analysis and print. We'll select all, add, close. Then let's go to design. Here we'll go to concrete, select the Indian code 456. So after save, after selecting the Indian codes, let's first select the parameters. Which parameter do we want to select? The FC, the FY main, the FY secondary, the maximum main, the maximum secondary, and minimum main, minimum secondary. These are all the statutory things that you can actually go on. I have another lectures for that where I have explained each of them. Let's have 35 MPa. Add FY main, let us have it as 500,000. Let's copy it. Everywhere we can just paste it and go. Secondary also the same. Maximum main, maximum main, let us have it as 25 dia. Maximum secondary, let us have it as 16 dia. Minimum main, let it be 12 mm. Minimum secondary, let it be 8 mm. Add, close. Let us assign all of them to view. Assign to view. To view, assign, yes. Assign to view, assign, yes. Assign to view, assign, yes. Assign to view, assign, yes. To view, assign, yes. Assign to view, assign, yes. Assign to view, assign, yes. Now let's go to commands. We will have a design beam, add design column, add design slab element, add takeoff. I always have this habit of adding a takeoff because it helps us in estimating the amount that we'll have. For designing beam, sorry, select beams parallel to X, select beams parallel to Z. We'll have this design beam, assign to selected beams, assign, yes. Design column, select beams parallel to Y, assign, yes. Design element, use cursor to assign, assign. Now just select them one by one, assign. So after having all this design command, let's go to analyze, run analysis. Now the things will start running, the analysis will start running, and slowly we'll have all our results. You can see the design of the shear walls is somewhat similar to design of the slabs that we have. See that analysis has started running. It is doing the concrete design. The process is totally similar, but the importance of shear wall is what you have to understand in a building, is where you have to incorporate. And sometimes also you can find that shear walls are provided up to a particular level. Say in a building, say we have this one, this building, we provide it up to this first floor level and then we terminate it. Those places actually what we do is that because we have a parking over here on the steel floor, what is the problem is that we don't get the stiffness that is provided by the brickwork. So we build a shear wall in order to give us the additional stiffness, right? So here we have this one. So let's view the output file. So in viewing the output file, we can see the beam design, the column design, the concrete design, application of load is just one, the notes, concrete quantity that has been given 76 m3, and there we have this element design. How much is the longitudinal reinforcement, top, bottom, top, bottom is the primary, secondary at the front face and the back face. It designs in a way that top, bottom is the, because it designs it in a platform. The same you get while doing it in our slab design. We also get the similar amount. Fine. So hope you like this video. See you in the next lecture.